Team back. Radiant team back. Dire team back. Radiant team pick. Dire team pick.
I speak for the trees.
Remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Dire team pick. Radiant team pick. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Dire team back.
League's assassin.
Radiant team back. Dire team back. Radiant team back.
All right, everybody, welcome back from your fresh Chill Hop jams. We are back in our caster stations. Dakota, your play-by-play. We got Jack as your co-caster, Lacoste, your observer, and of course, Lord Grant Harris as your king. Our draft is underway for game number two of the Dire versus Team Leviathan. Let's get into it, gentlemen. The picks are already underway. It is Team Leviathan grabbing up a Nature's Prophet and now taking in the Nyx Assassin for themselves.
Dire team pick.
While we have
the it's the same Chikero. Four heroes, but the Dire had the Nyx Assassin. Sorry about that, Dakota. Go on. Buck and Chikero being picked up by the Dire. That's pretty classic. Same thing we saw yesterday.
10 seconds remaining.
Nature's Prophet, Nyx Assassin.
5 seconds remaining.
Grimbreaker is banned, but did not feel too much of a presence in the previous game from that Nature's Prophet. Had a good laning stage, but he did not have any kill potential with the rest of his team. Have Dazzle, Anti-Mage, have Bloodseeker who can't really kill anyone. We need to have more like a stun-based lineup. This is Lacoste, your play-by-play, your commentator, and
you just took it upon yourself to just get in there and get that information out there, man. All right.
Back
I didn't
to
want
you,
stop
Grant.
You. No one here wanted to stop you. We were just ready to take it all in.
Sounds like a dispute that the king should settle.
No, he's doing great.
All right, and there it was said. The king.
Radiant
king.
Lacoste is now the only one who can talk during the entire game. Oh, shit. No one wants that.
Okay, guys, we're getting into the second pickup now, and things are getting a little different, so a nice little breath of fresh air to the meta. We got a Bounty Hunter popping out from the Dire. Leviathan just going to the AA. The AA is obviously feels like a pickup that's just more synergetic with them. What they want to do as a lineup, this isn't like kind of a counter pickup. They have Nyx Assassin who can set things up with Vendetta and the Ice Blast. Nature's Prophet to be able to get on the action globally. So this is very, if we're asking Leviathan to be able to play their own game, draft their own game, it looks like trying to do so.
Yeah, last time they third picked AA, they fourth picked the CK. So you don't want to do it again. Obviously, it makes for a very strong, like, aggro tri-lane. Even with Nyx AA, you toss on those little icy fingers and do a ton of damage.
A chilly fingers, I believe, is what you
want. Chilly finger or icy.
Radiant team pick.
So Bounty Hunter is something that we've seen. Peter and it. Let's not underhype this right
seen
now.
Bounty Hunter.
Peter is back drafting. It's been a long time since we've seen. I mean, other than the last
10 seconds remaining.
It's been a long time since we've seen that. Right? It's like drafting the competitive match.
Five seconds remaining.
Now, so kind of like a vision draft.
Called it. You're welcome, Jack.
Bounty Hunter, I don't remember seeing Bounty at all. I think Mouse was playing it a lot during the TI qualifiers, so maybe that's the reason why they did not qualify.
10 seconds remaining.
I don't feel the hero is particularly strong.
Five seconds remaining.
Though AA Nature's Prophet, especially for the Nature's Prophet, just be sure that there's no Bounty Hunter on you. You just need one guy to DP out if Bounty Hunter is just scouting you. It's a pretty scary kill for the Dire.
Yeah, I think we actually saw it. Planet Odd played it a handful of times during the qualifiers. Like
yeah, maybe
said,
that's
Misery's
why they
on
did
there.
Not qualify
that's
as well.
Why they didn't qualify, yeah. I know it's one of Misery's here that he actually enjoys roaming around on, though, and obviously Peter will be on the Jakiro, so Misery will have the Bounty Hunter. And that's one of those times Misery's probably like, yo, Pete, come on, dog, hook me up, and then he does, and we'll see if it works.
This is a hero that you love to see the old Wily Vets play, because, like, the movements on this hero, like, some people think there maybe isn't too much to it, but when you see someone like, even back at the
Radiant Team
back. Play like a Bounty Hunter, how they moved, or even, was it, Bald 7, like, you could see the difference. You knew how to move so well, the vision, the deep vision, especially if you want to see, you know, where Nyx is beginning their rotations, where everyone's coming from, the track, obviously, for the Nyx, Nature's Prophet, there's a lot to be said for
10 seconds remaining.
And no chicken safe ever.
Bone 7, babe. Man, that guy was
five
so
seconds
damn good
remaining.
At one time. He was the best. Fell off.
I don't know if I'm thinking of Pi or Bone on Bounty Hunter. I'm getting them mixed up. One of those guys.
Yes. So
back to you, Dakota.
Yeah, well,
CK, I find is still a bit interesting. Do you think it's a great pick here still? I mean, Grant's able to call it. It still goes along the lines that they're playing their own game. They're drafting their game on what they want to do. But normally, you know, it's great when the enemy doesn't have a lot of ways to deal with illusions. Do we think the Dire's lineup can deal with illusions? Ben Cleave, Jakiro, and
10
Puck.
Seconds remaining.
It's more than enough.
Yeah, so I'm still a little nervous for Leviathan
five
here. I'm happy to see that they're
remaining.
Trying to play their own game, but at some point, I see that there's a lot of counterplay potential.
Yeah, I think they just need to play a different
spin.
They're going to have like the same draft they did last time. They just need to play differently, right? Like, that's exactly it. They need to win the game by 30 minutes for me to like see this. They need to win their tri-lane with everything and then just go forward and just get as many kills as they can by 20 minutes and try to push space. Last time we saw BSJ just farm on Chaos Knight. This time, I know he's not the best tower hitter, but with these five heroes, you're just going to have to run over towers and kills. If not, Sven's just going to get farmed, and we've seen it in the past with BGJ. They may be losing a game, but you stack camps for Sven, Ritsu farms up, wins the game. I mean, it's going to be the same thing with PyCat. So what I'm saying is they don't win by 30 minutes, they lost. Or maybe I'm wrong, and then BSJ just gets a blink, goes Chessie, and just goes ham on the haters. I don't know.
Maybe it's Tidehunter time, or maybe even Enigma. I brought a shirt with Enigma, saying, wow.
Beastmaster.
Just like someone said. Is that you? Bill's Dakota, right? The Beastmaster Bounty Hunter? No, that was Jack. You guys all three sound the same.
Yeah, this is kind of the vision of a combo we've seen all solid moment before. Synergy obviously with the Jakiro as well, the attack speed. I'm a little bit worried for the Dire, I think more in this trap than the previous one, because if Sven, like, I feel like they might have issues with damage later on. They don't have a ton of, it's basically Sven, right, as like your core, dealing consistent damage as core. So that could get difficult later on as well.
But track gold, like, then Puck even just, you know, gets up those items super quick. I think it's just how quickly they get track kills. And if they get enough, then, I mean, it doesn't matter. You have, like, an axe on fucking 30 minutes.
Yeah, but look at that lineup. Once they kill one of the heroes, and with the track, they can just chase them down. They have so much mobility with the Warcry, Puck,
yeah.
Blink, Dagger, Beastmaster, Necro, Moose, Aura.
So it looks like... Who are we all thinking
prepare
has the favorite
battle.
Right now? We're all saying the Dire. We think anyone Leviathan? I like Leviathan. I think they're going to be the first
one
to 10
feel,
kills.
You always want to feel special.
Yeah, I did.
I think this could be a tougher game. I think
agree.
The Dire's got a harder draft to execute. I think it's nice that they're doing this. Like, I think this will be a test of like, the coordination. They're probably thinking that, you know, based on the last game, they have certain advantages. Skill level.
exact same spot.
They're coming prepared. BSJ bought up the dust. No stout shield though. He wants to get a first blood. Stout shield, get a wound. We'll have enough.
30 seconds to battle.
They drew out on the map though. Exactly where Leviathan May is rolling through. Once they see like nobody on the bottom half of this map, they gotta know what's talking about misery. Looking to go in pretty deep to get some good vision in here. Sandy boy on this one. First blood. Try and wiggle around.
The battle begins.
Forge dropping both.
Who's gonna get it?
Lost. Doesn't bother going for that. Should have tried to body block maybe Sam Boy.
You could you keep talking about it. He does have the orb of venom. Sam Boy definitely doesn't want to trade with him. Well, I mean, you would do more damage, but he doesn't want to waste time.
Sam Boy has a poor man's shield.
Yeah.
Anticipating to be bullied quite a bit here. CCNC just got off of a pretty good mid puck game, so warmed up and ready to play now. It's definitely going to be an aggro setup here from Leviathan up on top of the lane. Make it as best as they can for BSJ. Zai's going to have to deal with the lane, but he's got the boar and the bird to help him launch the
map. Hog sees new champ, wants the stun from the trees. Ain't happening.
He tried to bait out the stun. Bottom lane, we could see a possible approach as well. Misery is getting into action here. Jank is in the lane alone, but if not careful, could be caught out and stunned. Full breath has already been leveled up to deep, but could decide to go for an early ice pass to cancel out some attempted ice
pass. The biggest thing is going to be this middle lane puck. The Bloodseeker. Bloodseeker, you know, pops on that Q. Can heal up, do a little bit extra damage. He should probably win this lane in the earlier phase. I mean, the puck can just spam his bottle and all that. It's going to be rougher for him, but.
Yeah, the thing is, if Jenkins can keep those. Heroes low HP. Bloodseeker will win the lane and speed the damage. So you have no heal. This time we have every 2 tangos left. PPD no regeneration left, but we're sitting on a 60% HP. Off right now, so that's gonna be a big buff for the Bloodseeker.
Yep. Needs to definitely at least win. Bottom lane, they're going in finally. Nope, just more tries into nothing. There we go, CCNC gets wrapped down. Pretty hard here.
You need to have a lot of region when you're playing against Bloodseeker, especially at the early levels.
Well, this is a rematch of the last year's matchup, and we saw Sammy Boy kind of go for that first blood. Didn't get it, took a ton of tower damage, and CCNC was able to kill him short. A little different in terms of who's getting how much help this time, and maybe a better start here for Sammy Boy as well.
Yeah. The biggest thing top lane, right, is when they ran this aggressive tri-lane with the CK against Cole, they picked up the supports like 7 times, and right now it's just a solo Beastmaster up top, and he hasn't died yet and he's still getting experience, so the Dire is super happy with that.
3, back to the mid lane now. Sammy Boy eating some damage from CCNC, but Dushim is here. Zuri scrolls in from behind the nade. Now he's being brought down. Jenkins suddenly shows up. DP's into the mid lane. DP also shows up. They turn it on to Jenkins instead, and that's going to be your first die. He's going to get dropped in the top lane, but as that X breaks out, they know they have to jump. Safe jump.
Maybe he could have hit the S button there, but went forward, and the problem was
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
PBD also
hero Sammy Boy's got to be careful.
Silenced. A few more right clicks could do it, but Nushin's there. Bails him out.
He has very far already. He wants to dive back.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
One dead. It's pretty over.
So again, I mean, BSJ's leading the CS charts, but PyCat free farming again. Obviously, you're scared because Sven's always going to take ancient stacks and all that, while CK cannot do the same thing.
They are keeping Zai still in the solo safe lane slash off lane role. That's a pretty good way to kind of.
Zai doesn't care, I guess. Getting XP, Netsy can try to farm jungle a little bit. I mean, it really does not matter if you hit 6 BM at 6, 8, 10 minute mark. Not that big of a deal.
10 minutes might be a little late.
Nah, he's fine. He's not beating. They just need to get level 6 and farm counter and then back to the game if they're behind.
Bounty is flirting around the mid lane. There's more pressure on his Sammy, but still bloodshed at that point. Zai's been farming his way through the jungle. You can see that Jenkins is the same. But not really a safe place to be in now. The bottom lane with more levels on his hero and such. It's really cool for them to take advantage of the solo.
Yeah, Peter, I mean, they're just sitting dual lane in the bottom, so Peter's getting plenty of levels. They can push this tower down even level 4 when he gets level 2 Liquid Fire. It's gonna be pretty hard for Leviathan to hold towers, but middle lane, he always has to be nervous. He has to. They need to make him time his phase shift. Like, they're stacking stuns as well as the silence instead of making it like meant to one of them.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant's
structures.
You've got plenty of words to tell the story.
There we go.
Ready there we go. Nothing going. Happens. Back to you, Dakota.
Doing some fun wrestling down in the river, but yeah, like you said, getting on bar or anything.
Radiant's bottom tower is under
attack. The AA is using his chili fingers to just clear out the birds and the boars from.
Cold feed also works good at that too.
Yeah.
See a bird fly by. Cool.
It was the ESK get a TP on the bottom. Nice.
Up right now, and as they get the pullback here with the rip, they're gonna go for the right clicks on the PyCat. PyCat though gets off the stun, pop into the sprout.
Getting the wrong feed.
Well around
played.
Him, he can't find his way out. So the bird
mid lane.
Meanwhile, at the same time, he's going down to the hands of Sammy Boy.
Gets some of the damage on the bottom lane.
Can't be ready. Can't really keep down. When you're playing against the Bloodseeker, you need to have an urn carrier and have Tranquil Boots in your support.
Yeah.
Nusham the Stake here has been playing pretty well this game. He's connected.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
That nice gank bottom. That's, again, another point of concern. The ease of execution, I would say, is clearly in favor of life. They have more of a brute force. Kind of lineup, and people, of course, like, you talk about bombs and weakness. The hero doesn't really do much to fights later on. If you end up with this is a single core spend, if you're not in a good position, it's pretty hard to play that. Expect to end fights mid to late.
Yeah, oh, top lane.
Sprout, cold feet, but he quickly eats his way out.
I just thought of something, how to counter when you're playing Marion and someone has a no play. Crowd him and buy a branch and then try to use it wherever you think he's gonna use it right on the next level, but
seems like you might be spending a lot of gold.
Yeah. I mean, if you get
a
even
kill.
One kill, it's worth it, right?
Super style points, yeah. Imagine it being a GG branch too.
Yeah, the psychological cost of someone being tempted by a GG branch.
Yeah,
after they cut their way out.
Plus, if you see a Furion keeping with three branches and you have a Quelling Blade, you might buy some more tangles for yourself.
I mean, Grant, let's be honest here. I think half of India would just run down mid after they got styled up like that, right?
Yeah, that's probably true.
That's
I mean, they would have already been doing that before it happened, but.
Yeah. It's worth the 50 gold. The cost? Man, I can't wait to see it in our pumps.
Bottom. Orb out. They're trying to make some hero here. Return fire on DSJ. Shot on the board. Just barely the stun there. The rip pull back one more right click to do it. But the ice cap comes up from DVD. Even though the coil's gonna be dropped, it's not gonna be enough to save for a ton.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
again, looking a little rough around the edges, Dyer's right? He got faked out once attack. By BSJ, like, faking the Chaos Bolt, and he instantly phase shift. That's definitely nerves. Like, you should be able to phase shift a Chaos Bolt in the air.
He's too young to be nervous.
Oh, okay.
Dual breath. Sammy boy, he's carrying a bit now, because he's caught between three. Ice pass, dual breath.
It's a threat shift.
Trying, Rob. He's running.
There are shrine. There
pretty
is.
Durable.
He's good. Fine. He's fine. Right now. Gotta be a little sure now for the Dyer side a bit. Eyeball on two. Down in front of some of the kill potential of this
one. I think it's about dying. And then it comes back to change.
Stun. Full speed setup right there for Leviathan.
Top tower is under attack.
What's happening on the other side?
Using nothing on that spot to kill him with the extra move speed.
Oh, he
actually
went
up. Whoa!
Big
beating.
Oh, nice.
Jenkins got a kill on Pycat.
I think both
Wait,
games,
what?
Sammy Boy's gone with the max thirst build as well.
What?
Jenkins just solo killed a Sven who was two levels above him. With his side. I mean, it happened.
Maybe there was a Nexus set, but no Nexus set.
Charlie Chaplin. Charlie Chaplin has really let me down today, my man.
Yeah. I can't really.
He was good for his
time,
side. I think, but
at the same time.
Dude, looks like the potatoes are back though. They're back on the menu. They're out rotten right now.
Oh,
I love
crit,
it.
Crit. Crit. Maybe if he changed power threats, the agility could get one more time. Oh, damn it.
Grant,
do you notice the oldest little things I'm saying?
Yeah, he wouldn't have gotten extra attack and ability.
Yeah, you're mumbling, but we got you. They lost smart.
I just can't believe those little things.
Maybe you don't like that kind of smart something. You just like,
later. If you actually
rupture in the mid lane, gentlemen.
Head agility gives him one extra attack.
Oh, he's gonna be forced to dish out the coil. But Sammy boy, not to go down yet. Zygo running on
roll.
In. Yeah, he needs five more seconds. It looks like he's gonna be up.
I have ice design.
Dyer's top tower is under attack. Dyer's structures are fortified.
And then you saw like the issue with the damage output, right? Because they had three heroes up on the Bloodseeker. They dumped everything on him and they weren't able to kill him. And so basically it almost feels like you need Sven there to have the damage to even bring anyone down. And at this point in the game, that's not a position you want to be in, where you're depending on that core to do just about everything.
Smoke coming out from New Sham and Sammy Boy.
Yep. Head up towards the Dyer
Radiant's
woods
middle
here.
Tower
maybe
is
trying
under
to take
attack.
Advantage of a farming high cap. Zai's close by, but he has no mana to help him move away. They're going to need more assistance. He's trying to fill up in time, but the damage is down. Put the move in. Ice pass there. Usually
That's
seems
good.
To be the focus. They can get this track money. Ice blast! Does seem to catch Zai. Here's he's going to get the finish. On the other front, they do get the takedown. Zai ends up going down. Nice kick there from Sammy. Meanwhile, CCW does need to pick up on that AA.
The level.
Whip and pressure. You want to have heroes who pressure and harass people in the lane support. That again. That's the lane.
Yeah, this is what we want to see, right? But this is the thing. This is where it comes down to. We said they're going to get these kills early, but. What do they do after these kills? Right there, they just went back to farming. CCNC's finding farm.
They managed to take down Sven three times. Look at his farm. He's sitting top three.
Radiant's bottom tower
is under attack. I mean, if he had a good lane, goes against the what?
Nature. No, he was
no,
bottom.
Goes bottom.
Bottom lane, ice blast set up. Nuke him right there and damage the bot. And
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Pressure while top lane split pressure coming out from Leviathan here. Jenkins poking away at this tier 2 a bit.
So why did Jack, what's the main reason the Bloodseeker went evil for?
Set up his own combo.
What are your thoughts?
I guess just remove the stuns and dodge the stuns.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
They don't have
Radiant structures are
top lane, they're already behind Nusham, level 8 on deck, Nyx Assassin getting roared up.
They're moving in. Well needed, crack money in pocket.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Radiant's
top tower
yeah,
is under attack.
Stun has a cleave, has a stun, has a war cry, and a god very much grand.
Yep.
This is where the experience comes in. They have to be careful not to give back your advantage here. Taking a couple sloppy fights just now, just getting out-rotated. You saw this happen near the end of last game when things like really just started falling apart. But you're starting to see a little bit now, like the Bloodseeker maybe overcommitting mid, Nature's Prophet dying at his tower. They have to be careful in these skirmishes. You don't want them to catch up in both. Like rubber band gold and also with the track as well.
Radiant's top tower
yeah.
is under attack.
Radiant's
top tower is
Peter, like
Radiant's bottom tower.
Peter is dying a lot.
Radiant's bottom
yeah, I feel these are pretty effective deaths. So she's there to push the lane out. You are in the room, you're smoke hero.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
THD, the Chikiro. Like, where's the gain in that? Meanwhile, they're going to lose the Bloodseeker here.
Yeah.
Another
track,
a track kill. These
this
are just
is
bad
momentum.
Trades. Just get the gold for Dire.
This is just a lot of momentum coming together for the Dire right now. Track money coming into play and things kind of getting a bit uneasy for Leviathan. You just can't help but be nervous that once the gold advantage is now
Radiant's bottom
Dire,
tower
just
is under attack.
Leviathan to be
yeah, it's funny. It's like the exact opposite of BGJ. Like, Leviathan almost always wins the first 10 minutes of the game.
Radiant's middle tower
is
under attack.
Game, but where'd
Radiant
you rather
structures
win
are fortified.
Probably. Yeah.
If you kill the enemy throne, you're probably gonna win. Or mark it. Not the match leader throne for us.
Now you're just right.
Under attack.
Yeah. See if we're on. Blink Dagger is next up on the docket for him after completing the arm lift and...
I think with Chassy, he's learned. He didn't do this still before, but he probably did watch this. He's like, damn, that is a cool deal. This is smart.
I think this was going to be for the most easier to go for Radiant Stone.
Smoke out. Zai's moving in. He's got a roar in his pocket. He's going to get it out. On the one super, the jumping comes up with Pinecat, and they're going to burst him down. No chance at all. AA could be going next. Hit the foil setup. Comes in from CCNC. They will clear out after King Hero next. And then move in.
That was a pretty ball to move. Beastmaster has an Necro, has the Fox.
Roshan has fallen to the dark.
With the double hawk vision on the same place.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's middle tower
is fallen. Gonna die.
It does feel like the Leviathan, though. Destroy the laning phase, always up and kill, and then just, you don't have the heroes to...
Middle tower,
yeah,
they don't have the
heroes to do what they want to do. Damn, what awesome.
You guys are
married.
Like, finishing to set.
BSJ to get away.
Yeah.
But, oh, kind of a curious decision. It seemed like he wanted to fight when he felt cornered, so he committed the Phantasm. So that's going to be down for a little bit. Yeah, just an awkward exchange all around there.
Like we were just finding out that Ben losing the lane, but now he's 3k up on the map. See you later, bottom lane.
And he just got the road hit. Now we're going to see it again on the BSJ.
It was a track kill.
Doesn't have Phantasm, which is disrupted as well. He doesn't have the Midas to keep his turn, at least keep his
turn. Oh, Kurian beating 4 PPD. That's a dead silence already. Probably go down, one more hit, not enough.
The seeds of fortune.
Back into the fountain safe. Nice effort from Jenkins. He does manage to get that courage.
Now, that micro again, that time from PPD, the Dire. Their micro skills are not going coming into clutch right now, honestly.
And they're having problems with the birds.
Yeah, they really are.
There's three, like, old men on this team, right?
Yeah.
Relatively speaking.
Jesus, Jack.
What's old? Jack?
You never want to ask a man his age.
Tell me how old is old.
Actually, I don't think I consider Peter an old man.
He's definitely not. He's younger than me.
Alright, so there's really only two old
four,
men on this team.
Four of us have, what, the 123 years? Together.
Here's the criteria for being old. If you were playing professional Dota back in the Lacoste room,
what if they were playing?
And or if you actually played with them together. Both these guys did, right? I teamed with both these guys.
Yeah.
A cat?
Yeah.
Chinese calling it for 4.2.
They have these before.
Oh.
Last hit. Ruptures out.
Radiant's middle tower.
Forgiving
kickoff
from the way of Leviathan here while this does happen.
It's like almost every time a Dire hero dies, it feels like just massive overkill. There's like four losers and like three heroes and the Kanani underdies. But almost every time a Leviathan hero dies, it feels like it's like a four. It's like a Bloodseeker or a CK, which is like, does not want to be caught.
I don't think Shadowblade is the enemy hero. They already have one from this hero.
A lot of ways to see. This isn't one of those games.
is in the box and then outside the box.
The box took a long time
to
build.
When you go for that item.
Oh.
The box took a lot of knowledge and wisdom and experience to build.
Radiant Pandora are scanning.
Radiant's
middle tower is under attack.
Maybe a bit too much. Frozen up with the cold feet here as Nushu steps into action. They are going to be able to bring down this Ven. And it's going to be the Dire on your feet.
Or a Bossler. Real rough.
Micro chase for the PvP while the rest of the lives are taking the high ground to make a move in for this team. Silence. Nice ice bat though.
That was a rough fight. It looked like they were about to ditch him, but the Dire decided to keep the fight.
Dire
is
in the tower. Stop. So he can't move. He can't regen. These things can be countered.
I mean, is this a game? I don't know if we've seen games go on long enough. Bloodseekers still get, like, ags and stuff.
Regeneration!
I don't think it's needed. The primary target is the Swen. Maybe Puck. Puck can dodge a lot of stuff, so primary target should still be the Swen, so... the next Roche should be up in base spawn in 50 seconds. So that's where the Dire wants to fight.
What do you guys think Bloodseeker should do?
Bloodseeker, maybe... Man style is... That good up good dodge remove the sound smooth track can dodge strength stun. You can farm with it, give him some extra armor from the stack and then pace and maybe
things will probably make him beefier and more survival. He just needs to be to disrupt things and be alive by the time the Swen ult is done.
Oh, speaking of Swen, yeah, he jumps in and just still eats.
They're gonna go back to this.
Yeah, the RBS is running in. Oh, open fight that. AKB, turn and fight easily. Please down.
Oh,
I was mad. He just turned around and chunks with a Storm Ball, but they will manage to bring down Pike and slide into his own death.
And the problem with this one is that you run out of the items to bring him to that spot. He needs to keep that bone blade for the crowd.
Pretty much needs the blink. He's gonna want a link in his spot for sure. Maybe he can place a shield or something, but there are some slot limitations. And then again, when a team is gonna be so dependent on his damage to take, you know, those big team fights later on, it's gonna be really tough. He's gotta do so many things. The setup has to be perfect.
This is why I don't love the mana boots on a hero like Jakiro. Now you're sitting on 1.3k mana pool.
Radiant's courier has been killed.
What is hero? Goes down.
Yep.
Jack, is that a productive kill? Is that a productive death by misery?
No items.
It's alright.
Sorry. 50-50. Right.
Not the worst thing ever. You have to come back, you have to worry about the ward from place to it since he was found by Master Kenshiro, but he's got the deep ward out again.
I like how Leviathan's looking at the game now. Like, they understand, like, right, they lost a hero, their Furion, immediately, but they're like, wait, this Sven just popped everything, and he middle tower get out the league and track off.
On into the high ground for Sandy. Done for. That was a war committed, but it got straight from Titan. He's going to be out of this game without a buyback for over a minute. And just like that, gentlemen, a push for the tier 3. The tier 3 to go down. God, that accelerated quickly.
That is a lot less.
Rest.
That is a lot less fun.
Bloodseeker committed to buying a full Manta style there at least. What he could have done is try to bait with the Manta style. One of these illusions go on
scanning.
Farming like he just actually saw them there and he went to farm.
No You're
seeing the clear difference in how polished these players are, I think, between the experience of Vex, the Dire, and Full Life. And just like rotations, the priority of kills that you're getting, these little details people getting caught out. It's just a lot more crisp coming out from the Dire. And like, it's not to say that they haven't had their own issues to work out, but I think that's been a clear difference here between these two teams.
That's exact.
Now we look to see what is going to be next for Leviathan.
Radiant's
scenario.
Top shrine
stuff
is under
in
attack.
A defensive position where you just wait for the approach of the Dire if it comes with their Aegis.
Radiant's
hope that they make a mistake where you can hold the high ground. Or is there any reason for Leviathan to try to be proactive?
They have to do something. If they don't, they're just going to fall behind like 15k, but what can they do? They're going to look for the puck. It's almost impossible to kill Sven. You have to commit everything onto it. It could be rough. I think you just have to wait till the Aegis goes down.
Radiant's bottom shroud has fallen.
Yeah, maybe. This is it, right? 34 minutes now. We kind of gave them like the 30-minute threshold on Leviathan, and now they're versus Sven, who can just always farm moon shards, buybacks, all that versus
Sven
a CK.
Just salty. Probably a misclick.
Yeah, but whatever. They still have Aegis.
For the twins.
Look at him. He's cutting through those.
He might have done it
like
on purpose.
A hot knife through
armor.
Don't underestimate the wildkin cost. They have an armor.
Would you drop ulti right there?
Would I?
Yeah.
Probably not.
That's what you think?
Lincolns to put on the Sven, and they have a Lotus Orb as well from the Beastmaster. It reminds me a little bit of, remember when MP had those drafts early last year when they had like the Centaur or like the Sven, and they put like three Lincolns on
it?
Yeah.
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 Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Right about the man who's being split to an eighth. It went a little later than we thought, but
I saw that and I thought that to myself.
Yeah.
But
God.
You sure he didn't just hear Lacoste blaming him and just make an adjustment? He's got a blink up.
Radiant's top tower has fallen.
Yeah. He has a moon shard in his backpack. He Radiant's doesn't want to eat it. All his armor and the Sven just chunked him in like three hits. That was a little bit of a misplay by BSJ.
Given the situation though, I mean, if you said that the other team had a Sven with Aegis and that you'd be able to defend a high ground push without even committing Phantasm, I'd say that's pretty good.
But why didn't he commit? Now Puck gonna finally get some burst damage. That AA as well as the Nature's Prophet can definitely destroyed so easily.
Great that why they're able to survive is just a question of what can they do until the next time they have to defend again. It's gonna be a fight with that. But they come.
The seeds are
wrong. Tell me that they got something that they can't offer and that they can't do. They smoke and move up into the woods, we'll see some high cat illusion.
Also Dakota right again. Aghanim's on Bloodseeker. Dakota's just on fire right now. You actually are. I don't know what's going on.
Thank you, Grant. Bye, bud.
I mean, you did say that, right?
But thinking it's
that's all it took to
armor.
Bribe me 5 bucks?
Yeah, thinking it's more
right
armor. A solar crest would be a good choice. Just to try to tank it up with the AC. Maybe even get it to the guard is not a bad idea. Some extra armor, slow down for everyone. Provide vision, slow down those animals. I don't mean animals.
Maybe you just
brute
force with the rupture charges, you just brute force your way through the all the
you just
Lincolns.
Get too late. Yeah,
like,
I
I'm
mean,
gonna rupture you one way or another. It's coming.
I mean, he has the Yules now double ulti and stuff. Yeah, you can definitely do it, actually. He's always going to... Wait, what's the level 15 on Bloodseeker? He always goes blood, right? Is that where you're supposed to go always? Or?
That depends. What did you do?
Well, if he's getting Yules to, like, help set
yeah.
it up... And,
75 damage with magic this late game is like
pure damage. 75 pure plus you get extra damage from the blood damage.
Especially
and
it's
AoE, especially 25.
You end up getting the cooldown.
See, that's why you guys are the analyst and observer, and I'm just the king.
Radiant are scanning.
You guys to tell me, you know, a little more excitement though. Jack, why did he get it at 15 again?
With excitement.
Try one more time, Jack.
Maybe I should just tell you.
Not just tell me. Pure damage and AoE. My God, that is a good ability. You see, I got
wow.
you, Jack.
Oh, tussling. Lotus turns around, gets off the roar, but makes it.
That's the extra damage.
Dabbed on down. The other front, Shiro. Trouble.
An auspicious start to this fight.
Okay, two go down.
Enemy boy is going all in with the build. He wants to go for Ocarina. I always forget the name of that item for some reason.
You know what that was like? You know when you're reading like a book and there's like Dire's middle tower. There's like 40 different
cards. Yeah.
And each one comes to like its final. That's what it looks like. Every guy sounds like the solution to their dire hero that they fought, but the
most excited ever. Man.
Big bosses are still alive, the Sven and the Puck. Like,
the mini bosses?
Yeah.
Alright, so all three of you should know this. What did Ocarina, those ingredients, used to make?
They used to be the Agnum Scepter.
Yeah. Well, sorry, Jack, a little late. You can't just copy Code's answer.
Oh, terms of the more parallels.
Yeah, correct, Lacoste Jack. Can't copy Lacoste either.
Hell yeah.
No, that's it's crazy to think about, right? Agonist was that expensive back then, and people still got on here.
Yeah,
like,
and
that's
it also
a lot
worked
of money.
On like two heroes.
Yeah,
yeah,
you can find
Zeus
and Lina.
Yeah, that's it.
And it gave 100 extra damage to Zeus.
Yeah.
That's why my camera work is good, because I was always doing that.
No. Always looking around for that 100 HP, like, where am I?
That
was like the tilt equivalent. You want to inspire just raw hatred from your team.
Stealing
a
kill. Guaranteed,
somehow
yeah.
We always end up talking about the jungle Venomancer.
Well, the other reason is, look, they didn't use to track assists, right? So we're just like, hell, you didn't do anything this game. You were 1-0 because all your kills got stolen.
You just flexed the KDA
middle
back
tower
at them.
Is
what
under
are
attack.
You talking about? I'm 14-2.
Ooh, top lane, we have trouble.
That's the stuff we're talking about. He doesn't pop the BKB. Royal Zoe. Gonna be there. Snap. Yeah, he's locked in the plate. There goes the macro pyro, DPD, but VXJ cannot make it away. They're going to fall right through him. The rest of the wise and frantic to be able to make it out. They may have to turn and settle as they find focus onto Sandy and their crosshairs. They will chase him up to the high ground here.
They are running fast.
But he is fast.
They are running at 483.
See you later.
So is this like the second chapter of the book when like the bad guys hit back and a bunch of heroes die?
Ah, yes, I remember this book. Oh, bot lane.
I was a projectile stun.
But he was pretty mad at him. That was, Jack, if you don't think that was a quick reaction, I would love to see you play Dota and do the same thing.
Look, hindsight's 20-20. It's just
like, no, hindsight, that was a good play.
I could have seen Jenkins pop that BKB and throw himself in the zone. Oh,
yeah.
Shit.
Come on, guys, don't underestimate Mr. Potatoes over here. He's a professional player.
We're not underestimating. We're saying that was a great play. Crazy, Jack. Are you lost? Is this the third chapter of the book? Where Jack just gets lost?
No, we gotta get Jack to the back so he can find the index again. He doesn't know where the hell we are.
Also, the bounty hunter has a BKB. It's actually hilarious when he pops the BKB. I'm not sure why. I haven't seen this in a long time.
Yeah, he's been on a while now. He literally just
picked
that one.
Yep. I think so. Under no imminent pressure. He
said RIP. Oh, he went to the orb speed. All right. I'm hyped now.
Do you think CCC has a lot of practice with that orb speed?
I think it's got to be something you practice with. I'm pretty sure pros talk about it. It's like, how do you land your spells?
It like ruins it, yeah. Some people just can't do it.
And you're giving up a lot of gold, which I guess he doesn't need at this point. He's really rich. The orb speed can just be such a... He would just throw you off.
He's going to harness the power of the orb speed.
It's a double edged sword.
7 seconds, blood right cooldown with the Octarine Core. It's actually what? 3.75 seconds cooldown.
What?
you can use it every 4 seconds. Plus you have 2 rupture charges.
Cooldown.
Is it requiring 5 times? 40 seconds. I'm just gonna cap blood right.
Already up.
Pushing into that.
This is actually... This is an actual game changer.
We're witnessing greatness. He's got the mana regen from Yule, so it's 12 mana per. So it's gonna be pretty hard.
Part of a big plan, hot tech one. They lost the game right there. Nothing this would happen.
This game has entered like wild territory right now. There's like so much
there. We're in a western now, straight up. It's cowboys.
That's the essence of NA though. That's what we'd like to see.
Dude, why is this? So quick, we didn't see it.
Quick for our reserve.
Roche is about to go down here.
definitely just went into this is Leviathan's game now. They love this stupid stuff, like where you just like do stuff no one else has seen and you just try to abuse like the mechanics they want to. I'm enjoying it. I want to see this Blood Rage actually work in a fight.
Oh, imagine casting Blood Rage. He casts every 4.5 seconds on
Dire,
the Nyx assassin. Using mana for
Albuquerque, New Mexico.
Someone got kidnapped.
That's sad.
What the hell does that have to do with me?
Look at that.
I was here the whole time,
Zach,
man.
I'm just seeing. I don't know about that,
we
Zach.
We used to know. Zach, I see you gained some weight from last time, so it would be really hard to kidnap you right now. I'm just kidding, Zach. I love you.
It's a little bit harder than it was before, I guess, yeah.
Here comes trouble once again. The Dire approaching. See how many blood rites will take to stop this push.
And then that's the next one. What do you do with this back? With
Radiant's bottom barracks are under attack.
Yeah, it looks like it.
Radiant structures
goes in with
are
the Lincoln with the press for the BKB.
I'm moving with Rupture on you.
Starts chomping away, gets the racks down, and puts one in the other direction.
It's gonna be hard for Flint to actually fire.
And his blood rate, the melee
necrophilus. I'm not gonna get the fight at
Spell spam killed the book.
Yeah, spell spam killed the book.
Yeah, plus he got
killed.
The Dagon 5 with the blood rage on.
That makes he got changed. He was about to be in prime burrow position.
Yeah, trying to like ice bath and it just got disastered at that
there's
point.
There's just crazy stuff happening. The SJ wasn't back there, so they couldn't really like full commit to a fight. Just missed out on killing Pycat.
What do you think he's gonna go for? Reality Rift Pierce's immunity? He can use it on his life. BKB, which I can also bounty has BKB.
Sven has a 5% DKB and bounties at like 7 or 6. Still worth it, even if they have it.
I think
they're both.
The thing is,
he's pretty good.
He will have Phantasm.
Radiant's courier
next fight
has been killed.
Fire pops the BKB to run out the other side, and he'll be fine. TC though, steps in. They can't seem to follow up with any additional structure damage. That worth it? Oh, that helps you get tier 3.
Now that they only need those two top racks, without actually saying it, obviously losing your carry is never good, but they know they're going to have to fight into this.
Just look for it. It's a dark time. I feel like they're going to pretty morbid book, it's just a book of the dead, like it's just dead. Book of the ESJ?
Cat in the hat.
You're first.
Book of Dead.
No, you said that, LeCoq, not us.
He only died 2 times. He's actually with the least death, so that's not his.
Wow, he has only died twice. That's surprising, actually.
What's that?
I don't know. I felt
what
like
do you think
of
ESJ exceeds?
No, not at all. You
most of
can't
the time,
write a book
and this is
about
why
somebody
it's
who does that.
This book is very judgmental. Mid lane, trouble for misery. Ice blast, surrounded by 3 goons.
might just go farm a buyback.
That might see like a frantic play from like side to push side lane.
Yeah.
What if they get that?
Wait a little longer and go mid.
No. Comes out the front door.
If they actually get him here, that would be.
Peter has. Peter's gotten a completed assault around here.
And an ag. Where did this happen? What happened?
150 volts. Similar to Keeper, where you could just blast through waves. And fall.
The Ag's Macropyre, by the way, is
I love
like
that. With Aether Lens?
With giant, fiery, earthy.
You cast that
so
thing
good.
From, like, another world. That's how
yeah.
far away
it is. You lay it down, people in different games.
Yeah.
You just drop it in, like, the middle of, like, a
now,
high ground push.
Why does this happen? Look at my screen.
I think that's really good.
Monster kill!
No, but everything goes down.
Run the other direction, ruptured up. Now caught under the blood by Sammy, thinking about moving in, then doubles back, goes in once again.
Oh, damage!
Gets hit so hard, the Yule's almost there to save him, but he managed to bring down Pycat. There's still trouble around, though, as Misery tries to head out undercover, under his BKB, but he's gonna be safe.
Dude, this Sammy boy build's actually just mind-blowingly good right now.
Yeah, can if get armor instead of that Yule Scepter
yeah.
can eat. Or butterfly. Not butterfly, because it doesn't have that KB.
Uh-oh. Top lane. They're still hunting.
Misery's here, creeping in from behind a BSJ Chiro duo.
It's kind of sad, though. Like, why did he get Ags? It does no damage in late game.
Secret has no buyback for the next minute and a half.
The maximum value has not been extracted from these buybacks.
Oh yeah, the accidental one and this one. Yeah.
Problem is, you use Rupture on a buck, he goes way too quickly out of it.
He's not
going to
get a chance to fight back here.
He has a buyback though. There's a Roche up and there's a double damage.
There's like some first strike going on.
Yeah.
Like whoever gets like.
I really think they can control this puck, especially Bloodseeker does have a Sheepstick queued up next with the lower cooldowns and all that. It'd be pretty rough for this puck to try to get away, especially now that he has so many earned charges on the deck. It stops his blink. It's actually super good late game. You always stop his blink, purpose silence, and sheep him.
Yeah, he's preparing for the super ultra late game. It's 60, 60, seventh
those
minute
are the things,
plus.
Those are the options you get with 10 charges that you don't have with like 3 or 4.
Yeah,
they really need to just have an earn level 2.
Nyx needs to get to level 25.
So even if you're CK, right, you just want to get the hell out of there. When
well, the thing is, any more fat. Save for buyback, get the refresher orb, maybe get a moon shard, but get a moon shard.
How will that solve anyone's problems?
He has it. I'm just wondering if he has the GC. I thought he's way off of it. Damn.
No, he's got it. He's rich. He had like 6,500 gold in there.
If they just... There's no way there's a successful smoke gank this late in the game, I don't think. But if they somehow get one on the puck, they could just run and win the game, it feels like.
It's like a little bit of lag here coming in for Leviathan boys.
I wonder if they're boot camping. I know Slayer and BSJ have boot camped before. Maybe they're back at that same house. Because it feels like if they, maybe it's just one guy, but it feels like they might all.
Remember the Leviathan used to have a team house together?
Yeah. Dude, that'd be good. That'd be like 5 team houses. NA's really moving up.
Yeah, it's in the Shrimp Street. 3-2-2.
Yeah.
This has turned into
Cali.
An epic game.
Yeah, this will be probably our longest game in the league so far. And who'd have thought the Dire versus Leviathan would have led to this?
Oh, yeah, I did before the restart.
I thought this game might be over super soon, and then Sammy Boy, his build is actually what saved him from the 40 to 60 minute mark now. I hope we see this in pubs. Because I don't play him, I don't get shit.
That poor man, Naga,
push out. This week's pub report, every Bloodseeker is a counter.
Octarine burst item.
This is one of the weirdest talents on AA. Plus 30 health reasons makes no sense, no synergy with the spells or whatsoever.
He's in his own game. Yeah.
I love it because the way AA you always used to be played, it was like, he'd be on the other side. You actually want to be on the other side of the map.
Shoot 3-pointers.
Yeah. But now that this makes him much more durable than Mike, he can actually stand and hang and bang a little bit.
Master Control almost found CCNC.
Side, they see him now, he's stopping him. Stop on his side.
That's a 5-back available, but they're getting killed.
And Ice Vortex is not to be underestimated. It's got a very short cooldown, actually it sounds quite a bit in terms of slow attack.
Remember, it increases his move speed, too.
Yep.
It does not even say it.
Wait, Dakota, you told us you were ice running for this game.
I should go back to beta testing or at least do some
There's
work.
There's video evidence
well.
Of that, haven't you seen
managed
the clip?
To see like 3-4 things to fix already.
They have the agent. Alright.
Dire structures are fortified.
Confident way to steer three here. Slashed apart. Pretty effortless feeling takedown right there for the Dire, and it looks like they will be able to keep that control. Tier 3 is the only casualty there for them.
Survivor though, sure, the split push a little bit on the bottom. Jack, why am I doing your work?
You just take it upon
You've
yourself.
You've been doing everybody's work.
Yeah, man, you're just a workhorse today.
Yeah, my throat hurt yesterday. All too much.
Yeah, my bad.
A bit better. Yeah, that's reach the throat.
It hasn't stopped you today.
takedown from Jenkins.
The guy. The bad man.
Wait, is that a... Is that the sheep stick on Peter?
That
was a void stone.
Precious void stone.
It was.
You can
serious.
Buy a new one.
You should.
I mean,
that's
this is
back
the wealthiest material that I've seen. Just, at some point, people are just like, alright, you guys clearly can't finish this game. I'm gonna just get out of the way. He's got 367 last hits.
I
on Jakiro.
Swear to the heavenly hopes.
That's a lot. I mean, when's the last time you saw that many last hits on Jakiro?
I don't remember.
But
Grand, can you handle this?
Alright, someone... I probably should, never mind.
Do you want me to write something?
Nah, it's good. We better keep it professional.
Not bad at all.
Nah, but, I mean, the joke there is, you know, when we're playing FPL NA, people want to pause the game, and if they don't have a reason, I tell the other team they can unpause.
Yeah, you have...
Pauses can eat a D. That's all I'm saying.
I actually hate pauses. How many
so
second
much.
Window after you hit the pause button to type it out?
I can type it out in less than a second. Now.
Like, is sec count as a valid reason?
No. Okay, what's a sec for? If they just say P, sure. Literally just a reason. No sec, just tell me. P, cat, dead, tornado, hurricane.
Yeah.
Anus, splinter, I don't know.
How much time do you give for cat dead?
God,
2 minutes. Everyone's 2 minutes. That's
two
it.
Minutes,
as long
that's
as you
it?
Give
that
me...
That sounds pretty savage.
I don't care. Well, maybe your cat should have died while you're playing. I don't know. It's not my fault to die.
They probably forgot to feed the cat because they're busy playing FPL.
Exactly.
So, you know, lesson learned.
It's true. Here's my biggest thing. You know what my hatred is?
Yeah.
When I actually play PUBG, someone pauses at the beginning of the game, and then they get mad that I unpause it. They're like, why'd you do that? Guess what? You clicked the...
Pause.
He clicked the ready button, right? You have to click a ready button to get into a game, correct?
Yes.
Okay. So why do you click the ready button if he wasn't ready, Jack?
That's a good point.
Because he does not want to get 5 minutes
penalty. I think now is an appropriate
penalty.
Time for a segue into the Chinese scene. So frequently in Chinese scene, when someone needs to pause, people actually will pause. Like, they'll give you the time and they'll wait.
Yeah, but you need to give a good reason.
No, no, you
give whatever,
you
like,
pause
a piece of the game out of them.
I will.
Oh, pause on those spots. Moving from high tank.
Chomping away.
Now can we get Battle of the Titans and BSJ wins it.
BSJ is better than PyCat.
You saw it here first, folks. Put it on Reddit
2017.
Right now.
One Titan is falling. Loki dead. The Morgan is the only one alive.
Morgan? I didn't have that comment, but I wish I did.
Yeah, it was...
So they've got to go. They've got to go now. PyCat is able to buy back, but he's not going to have to upgrade for a little bit. So this is just...
Morgan
and
his finugler.
Peter does
ring.
Not have
just
boots of
moment.
Shot.
Just
it's under
moment.
Attack.
Jack should sell Soul Ring to get Vladimir's offering up for the extra armor and life steal for another one.
Man, he has no buyback.
Oh, Bloodseeker comes in.
Sid lost the game, I'm pretty sure.
They can buy back though. At least on a Bloodseeker.
Yeah. No fury on for 120.
Well, we're officially in the book 5 here.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Peter's already inside their base, happy to just have those tier 4s already, but the rest of Leviathan can't even make it back home without taking damage. You see, he goes down, he's going to be out for good. And this one now falls all on BSJ, Sandy, Ferrer, and Zeus.
Whoa.
To somehow defend against the push and Omegas. Good luck, Jerry. Tier 4 is also going to fall.
That's a dieback on 5-10.
Radiant's middle
tier 4, but now what do you do with the Leviathan map?
I'll tell you what.
So you can't just rode in like Gandalf over the hills in, you know, in Lord of the Rings to save the day.
Did you know Gandalf and Dumbledore are brothers? No, alright. Cool. Thanks, guys.
Is under attack.
I don't know.
You know Gandalf the Grey and Gandalf the White aren't actually the same person. Definitely needed that, right? That was their first two wins. Obviously, they lost to Infamous early, the very first day.